No doubt neural networks can handle extremely complex data sets, but as the size of the neural network increases, it is more prone to overfitting. Overfitting happens when you are dealing with large neural networks. In it, the model performs excellently on trained data but poorly in the test data. The traditional way to fight overfitting was to use early stopping. In early stopping, what we do is stop the training as soon as our deep learning model starts overfitting. Like in this plot, this red line is training loss and this blue line is validation loss. Training loss is decreasing with every iteration, and you might think that your model is still learning, but no. Validation curve is the performance of our model on the unseen data, and the loss on unseen data is decreasing till the 6th epoch, and after that the validation loss starts increasing. That means after the 6th epoch, our model has started to overfit. Now what we will do is stop the training as soon as validation loss starts to increase. In our case, we will stop the training at the 6th epoch, so overfitting will never happen. So this was early stopping. But there is one small problem. We are not curing overfitting, we are just stopping the entire training as soon as it happens. What we want is to reduce this error gap between training and validation, or in another sense, to reduce validation loss even more. This is what Dropout does. It helps us to cure overfitting and to decrease validation loss even more. In Dropout, we randomly drop neurons, hence the name Dropout. For example, now I will drop some neurons from layer 2, 3 and 4. I have dropped 70% of neurons from the second layer, 50% of neurons from the third layer, and 80% of neurons from the fourth layer. The complexity has been quite reduced compared to the previous neural network architecture. So this makes the training process faster as neurons have been reduced and prevent overfitting. But what's the connection between dropping a neuron and overfitting? Suppose you are creating a neural network architecture to classify images of pandas and dogs. Therefore, every neuron in this neural network will handle a single feature from this image. Like this neuron will take care of the eyes, this for the nose, this for color, and so on. So as training process, neural network will get overly reliant on some of its neurons. This will cause the neural network to overfit the data. For example, let's imagine our model is overly reliant on features like eyes and nose and does not give any importance to feature like color. So if you pass a picture of panda sitting like this, when his eyes and nose are not visible, our neural network will freak out and won't be able to predict these kind of images properly. Only if it had given some importance to this feature, color, it might be able to guess it, because in this image, color of the panda is still the same. To cure this problem, we drop the neurons. So for example, in the first iteration, these sets of neurons all dropped, and in the second iteration, some other sets of neurons will get dropped. This will refrain our model to overfit and getting overly reliant on some set of neurons. You can actually control the number of neurons you want to drop in each iteration. In TensorFlow documentation of Dropout, there is one mandatory argument known as rate. This is dropout rate parameter that tells the dropout layer to drop that fraction of neurons. You can see it is written float between 0 and 1, fraction of the input units to drop. So for example, a layer has 128 neurons, and if we set the dropout rate to 0.1, then 10% of neurons will get dropped, which is about 13 neurons, and the same for various dropout rates. As you can see, when the dropout rate is 0.8, 102 neurons are dropped out of 128, and at 0.9, 115 neurons out of 128. So which dropout rate to choose? That will give us the most efficient answers. Let us understand that by a graph. Here the x-axis is various dropout rates and the y-axis is loss at that dropout rate. Red line is training loss and the blue line is testing loss. As you can see, training loss is less for every dropout rate after 0.3, but testing loss first decreases to 0.3 and then become flat from 0.3 to 0.6 and then again increases after 0.6. This happens because after 0.6, so many neurons are getting dropped that it is hampering the performance of the neural network. That's why dropout rate between 0.3 to 0.6 is recommended for best results. This was it for today's video. If you want to go into more details, you should check the description. Till next video, see my other videos, and if you are from the very future, I may have already uploaded many videos in this series. So you can get this playlist link in the description. See you in the next video.